Andrew Eldridge attended Oxford University in the hopes of becoming a diplomat. That was before he started the band Sisters of Mercy in 1980. Hi, I'm Erica M., and our spotlight today is the Sisters of Mercy. The band found their name by basing it on an order of nuns that was founded in Dublin in 1831. The first album was called First and Last and Always, and it went straight to the top 20, but the pressures of touring and supporting the band was a little bit rough for Andrew Eldridge, who got very sick and had to stop touring. The band kind of split up a little bit. A couple of members went off to form The Mission, and the sound changed a lot. But through the 80s, they kind of rediscovered themselves, and now the lineup is pretty much stable. Most recently, the band did a major tour. It was called Tune In, Turn On, and Burn Out, and it was in conjunction with Gang of Four and Public Enemy. It was kind of one of those rock meets rap tour. It was interesting that recently Andrew Eldridge described himself as an Elvis meets Kierkegaard character, and you can judge for yourself in our spotlight on Sisters of Mercy right after this.
Oh, I'm like Jesus, you know, omnipresent even in my absence. No, I'm not the kind of hippie person that ever gets involved in organic drugs. I don't approve of that. Associated with a perverse amateurism, which I don't approve of. I always regarded myself as having my own major label, a very poor, very inefficient major label. I think it's interesting to note that my band was never, ever, ever, ever offered a deal by an independent label. I don't see how we come to be regarded as so very independent. I'm not sure really what that means. No independent label ever wanted anything to do with us.
Getting on stage was like being caught in the headlights, you know, like a rabbit.
Yeah, it is.
How do you go through that each time?
Well, it makes life interesting. I mean, for 5 years I haven't been through it, but I decided that life needed a bit of a jolt, so life was very comfortable. I thought I'd go on the road again.
So doesn't it make you feel sick each time?
Yeah. Yeah, but it's, you know, it's like I'm not going to get too deep at this point on the subject of drug abuse, but there's a similar kind of rush involved. I'm not the kind of hippie person that ever gets involved in organic drugs. I don't approve of that. It's a very synthetic kind of rush that you get off being on stage. It's very unnatural. That's the kind of stimulant that I like, sane reactions in an insane environment.
Tell me where the manhole's deep. A little girl waits on my station.
as we're talking, there's bombing going around the world.
I was just wondering, I got CNN, and that's right. I've got the glass. I'm not actually looking at you at all. I'm watching CNN as we speak over there.
Yeah, well...
Far more interesting, far more relevant than pop music. Things like the Gulf War just goes to prove one's general point about the wonderful idiocy of politics. I don't think it doesn't change anything. It's a fairly obvious step along a fairly insane route.
I need all the love I can get. Independence Festival und die Telefonnummer 38